911, where is your emergency?
3 years ago, a tiny baby, just 29 days old, was thrown from her stroller and landed in a Tempe gutter.
She was in the ICU. She had a brain bleed.
Her mom was tossed 30 feet, and when she crash-landed in some rocks, her skull was fractured in three different places.
They told my husband, pretty much, I shouldn't be here.
Amy Kiefer-Berard can't remember that day. She didn't wake up for nearly a month, and when she did, the high school teacher had to learn to walk and eat all over again.
I pulled 7 feeding tubes out of my body. I couldn't even eat. And that's because this guy decided to text something.
The family was crossing the street when they were hit by a car that was rear-ended by a guy who was texting and driving. He was cited only for driving on a suspended license.
No charges were brought against him for what he did to us.
What do you think it's going to take for Arizona to pass a law to ban being on your phone while driving?
If we died. I think if we hadn't recovered, and I mean, they put a teacher and a baby in the grave, things would have changed.
But even the highly publicized death of DPS officer Tim Huffman the very next year has not changed the law. Video shows truck driver Jorge Espinosa on his smartphone when he plowed through several emergency vehicles along I-8. Officer Huffman died at the scene. Espinosa's lawyer said there was no law banning texting and driving, and that's not for lack of trying.
I was the first legislator in the country to propose banning texting while driving in January 2007.
Senator Farley.
When he did, Senator Steve Farley was ridiculed. It was said he was wasting his skills on a bill that had no hope of passing. He has tried every year since with no luck. Yet in that time, nearly the entire country, 48 states have recognized the public safety epidemic and passed some sort of ban.
So it's particularly sad that we're one of the last two in the country that have no ban on anybody using texting while driving.
Farley believes his foresight 9 years ago could have made Arizona roads safer. Instead, he says, driver safety in our state has been compromised by politics.
There's been primarily one person who has disagreed with this to this point.
That person is the most powerful man in the state Senate, Senate President Andy Biggs.
He doesn't think more laws in the books will make a difference.
There are seatbelt laws, DUI laws, and texting bans nationwide proven to make a difference. So what is it with Arizona? We tried for weeks to ask Senator Biggs, who would not go on camera.
Can you just answer a couple of questions about the texting law?
It is a question national safety groups like StopDistractions.org are now asking as they focus their attention on our state. And for the past 5 years, cell phone campaigns like AT&T's It Can Wait have been raising awareness of the danger, which now include the rampant use of social media.
Through research, we found out that 7 in 10 people actually post something or do something other than texting while they're driving.
The campaign travels the state sharing personal stories of loss.
Yeah.
They also use a simulator to show just how quickly things go wrong when you take your eyes off the road. I tried it and it took my breath away.
Boom. People are honking. Oh my God.
I mean, it's really about trying to change a behavior.
We have specific laws about DUI, we have specific laws about speeding, so there's no reason we shouldn't have a specific law about something like driving while texting, which is as dangerous, if not more dangerous, than even drunk driving.
Today, Amy Kiefer-Berard has 2 little girls and is still getting help for her traumatic brain injury. She says everyone knows being on your phone behind the wheel is wrong, but points out that personal responsibility and common sense aren't cutting it.
If we're not responsible enough to take care of ourselves to think about it, then maybe we need a law on the books to say, hey, you're not going to think about it, then we're going to make you think about it.